welcome back to Doug's Cars. Today, it's a black Cayenne Turbo. And what happens when one of your friends gets one? Well, you steal the keys and you take it for a joyride.
Yoink.
And just like that, I'm inside it. JK, don't steal your friend's cars. I obviously had permission to do that. But hey, it's a second gen Cayenne Turbo. I'm not gonna turn that down. He just picked it up. From what I understand, got a good deal on it. This thing looks amazing in here. I'm gonna take it for a drive, and then when we get back, take a look around. Ooh, I'm seeing cooled seats. Where is the start button in this? Oh, it's one of these. Oh, I actually have to put the key in. Oh, okay. Oh, move the seat in. And turn the radio on. Let's go ahead and kill a radio there. All right, let's move that back. It's actually supposed to sound amazing because it's a 500 horsepower twin turbo V8. So let me open the door and let's start it up. Oh yeah. That's awesome. I'm gonna turn on my cooled seat because it is a warm day, as you can probably tell. Okay, it's warmed up for about 10 seconds. So I'll blip the throttle a couple times because I'm not Captain Cold Rev. Yeah, that's awesome. Just ease out onto the road here. Wow. So this actually has about 140,000 miles on it, which is surprising because it doesn't look like that in here. The interior is immaculate. Whoever had this before obviously took really good care of it, and I'm gonna do the same because it's my buddy's brand new to him car. You can't beat the sound of that. I mean, it is not a horizontally opposed flat six like in a 911, but dang, that sounds good. I mean, it's really nice in here. Stitched leather everywhere on the dash, like you'd expect. I mean, you've got the navigation in one of the dials on the dash, which is always good, because this is, again, you know, this is a second gen, so this is an older model, but it still has plenty of higher end technology just because, you know, it was a very expensive vehicle to begin with. So they put everything in here, you know, it's like an S-Class, you get all the good stuff. You can probably still hear me. I know he's on a call at work right now going, he's giving it too much gas. No, this is meant to be driven, obviously. And I've never driven the second gen Cayenne. I've driven the first gen Cayenne. Unfortunately, I didn't make a video of that. Troy of Addicted Motors had one in at the shop that they had as a shop sale vehicle, and it was a Turbo S, first gen, and that thing with the air suspension hauled a double, you know what, that thing was amazing. So this being a second gen, you'd have to think, you know, it's less of an off-road vehicle because the first gen, you know, shared its platform with the tow rag, which I guess this does as well, but I'll try to pull it on the main drag here. But of course, it's a construction zone, and it's like 4 o'clock, so those people who still go to an office are probably driving home. I really do like this interior. I mean, it's got like Alcantara headliner all around, and everything else is just nice gray leather, dove gray, I guess. I mean, it's got, really has leather everywhere. Looks like it has, oh, it's got auto hold too. It feels like, no, it's creeping, it's creeping. I thought it had that old auto hold feature where, I mean, they're just still coming. Auto hold was great if your car has it. This one doesn't because it's a little old. That's fantastic. And I know you heard that. Hopefully that came out well on the camera because, you know, audio issues and all that happen, but this thing is amazing. I could totally see why this is something you would want to have and drive around in and enjoy. I mean, this is the perfect daily driver. I mean, other than the fact that it's a Porsche with 140,000 miles on it, which can lead to its other issues, but it's got an actual like oil pressure gauge, temperature gauge, we got gas, and of course engine temp. Shows you what gear you're in. Obviously it's got the big turbo on the tach. I'll show some of this when we get back and I take more video of it, but I wanted to hop right in and go because I didn't want him to change his mind and say, oh yeah, I left the key out for you, but yeah, the key's gone for some reason. So had to hop in and take it. too much traffic here. I'll take some side streets, although I can't really do a whole lot on the side streets because this thing has 520 horsepower or something, and you know, that's just ridiculous. It's awesome, but you know, 25 mile an hour speed limit, you can't really use it a whole lot without getting in lots and lots of trouble, and it's not my car. But even if it was my car, I probably shouldn't do that too much. Man, this thing's cool. I'm taking it on a really rough road, and not on purpose, but this is the way I came, and it actually feels really good. Like, it drives surprisingly well, considering I've only ever driven the other one, and I do have an SUV that has air suspension, of course, my Land Rover LR3, Discovery 3, for those of y'all outside North America, and I'm used to that, but of course, this is a Porsche, so it isn't wallowy like the Land Rover is. It feels very tight, and the steering is very direct, and I had a first generation X5, the E53, which was a 3-liter with the sport package, and it was a 5-speed manual. Yeah, they made 5-speed manuals and then 6-speed manuals. And so that's kind of always been a benchmark for me, but you know, that I had that car so long ago now that I don't remember everything about it. I mean, I bought it new. I ordered it from the factory. And so I do remember how good it was changing lanes, especially at speed, like on the interstate. Something happens in your lane and you have to change lanes. It changed lanes as close as to a sports sedan as you could get in something that tall, to the fact where I had friends in the vehicle once when this happened, and when I changed lanes like that, they looked at me like I was crazy, and then as soon as the lane change was done, they're like, oh, that was amazing. I can't believe that this thing handles that well. And I assume that this is, if anything, better because it's, you know, more than 10 years newer than that X5 was. All right, pull out here, give gas. Now a little bit more. Speedo goes up to 180. Did not use most of it. That was more than I was willing to do. So yeah, this thing's awesome. It just goes. It goes immediately and instantly, and I highly recommend driving one of these if you can. Before I use up all of his gas, flooring it all the time, I'm gonna start heading back towards his house, but I definitely need to thank him profusely for letting me play with this, because this is not something I get to drive normally. It's awesome. This thing's so cool. It really is. I get to do one more high speed turn out of this side street onto the kind of the bigger road, and that'll be the last one I get to do, unfortunately, but coming. So he said that something's been done to the exhaust to customize it, I believe, and that he was gonna maybe have to tune it down just a little bit there, but I mean, it doesn't make noise at speed. You don't have the droniness of some exhausts that, you know, you're on the highway for 8 hours and it's going, you know, what's the worst sound in the world, right? That sounds awful. This doesn't do that. It definitely does that on startup when you take off, but it's a V8. That sounds fantastic. And yes, it sounds so good at low RPMs when you first start taking off. And I mean, it just has endless amounts of power. It's effortless to drive. And like I said a few minutes ago, you can easily get yourself in a lot of trouble with something like this. Wow. It's going over these terrible roads in the neighborhood near where I live. They are just absolutely destroyed. And it's got big wheels on it. It doesn't have little tiny 16s with a bunch of sidewalls. So this suspension is really, really good. And around this guy. Yeah, oh, there we go. Towing a trailer. Obviously, I'm enjoying this. I'm grinning from ear to ear. I don't have a high-performance vehicle anymore at the moment. Gotten rid of all the ones that I had. But at some point, I will get another one, obviously. And this checks a lot of boxes, honestly. I mean, you've got the Stuttgart crest on the hood. You've got acres of room and leather inside, so it's very comfortable, and this would be a great high-speed cruiser. This checks a lot of the boxes of, right now I have two vehicles. One's my long-speed comfortable car, and one's my inclement weather car. This kind of does both. That's me thinking a little bit. The problem is, I would run through tanks of premium like that because I would do this every time. And I'm not even giving it that much gas. It's just a, like a third of the throttle at most, and it's making that amazing sound. I don't know if I'd want to wake up all my neighbors at 5 in the morning doing that, but hey, that's the price they pay for living next to someone cool enough to have a Porsche Cayenne in the driveway. This definitely has me thinking. I kind of like this. I liked the previous gen that I drove when Troy had it, but you know, that was also like 15 plus years old, and for a daily driver, I didn't want to have it at the time. Daily driver is now a 15-year-old Land Rover with 230,000 miles on it, so obviously I'm insane, but this is pretty cool. I have to look into one of these at some point, depending on what the values are. I'm not entirely certain what he paid for his, but I'm gonna be doing a little bit more research on these just out of curiosity now that I've gotten the chance to drive one. And other than just basic knowledge of these and having to look up on Wikipedia real quick as I went over to his house to drive it, I know more than a layperson, but hey, this thing's cool. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and get it parked up and go ahead and show you around the vehicle a little tiny bit after we've had the fun part of driving it. Well, so you can see it's actually got a very high-tech gauge there telling me I haven't removed the key yet. I will go ahead and do that. And then it goes back to Cayenne Turbo, and the steering wheel raises up out of the way like it is a fancy German luxury car, which it is. You've got your screen here that's pretty high-tech. It has the Sport Chrono package, which probably came with the Turbo, and you can see it's got all of the buttons here, which is awesome, and all of the height adjustments for the suspension and everything. But yeah, cooled seats, very cool. I mean, just look at the leather in this. Look at the stitching. I mean, and it's on the door. You got your Bose speakers. You've got all of your controls here. Fold the mirrors in, and wow. I mean, this is in really nice shape for a 2011. I think it was the first year of this generation was the 2011. You've got all your overhead console buttons here. Hey, it's me. It's Doug from Doug's Cars. This is really cool. Oh, man. I mean, the seats are just in immaculate shape. This whole bolster slides out electrically. Not electronically, as Doug DeMira says. That's one of my pet peeves. It's electric, but yeah. Let's hop in the back real quick. And see, there's plenty of room back here for what this vehicle was designed for, which was carrying people. Like, I'm like 6'3", and I fit fine behind the driver's seat. It's great for kid seats. We've got an armrest with the requisite cup holders, of course. Plenty of room back here. And the Alcantara headliner is fantastic. And it even has LEDs here. And that looks like LEDs too. Oh, I don't know if they were replaced by the previous owner or not, but cubby hole here. Yeah. This is really neat. Let's check out the trunk. Yes, we can. Ooh, power lift gate. Check out the room back here. Now, I can't imagine there's a spare underneath here. Oh, there is. It's one of those funny looking things. Space Master, temporary use only. This thing has 21s on it. That's massive. Cargo nets. Looks like it might not have the cargo cover, although maybe he's just taken that out. Hey, some type of electrical connector. Nothing fun there. Oh, that's funny. Put the VIN back here on a sticker, because the sticker can't be, like, changed by someone when this is stolen and sent to Russia. But what is this? Oh, ooh, ashtray. That's perfect for the rear seat passengers who are normally kids. Gotta love that. Well, just want to thank him for letting me borrow his new prized possession. This thing is awesome. The X pipe underneath this is what makes all the noise, which bring in the noise, right? This thing sounds great. I know I'm gonna hear him ripping through my neighborhood all the time now, and I'm just gonna have a smile on my face every time I hear this thing drive off. Thanks y'all so much for watching Doug's Cars. Thanks for this quick look into this 2011 Porsche Cayenne Turbo. And come back for more, hit subscribe, and we'll see y'all soon.